renewable energy, looked to as the future as it brings both environmental and economic benefits. South Korea is also jumping on board with Seoul declaring itself a future solar city. For our news features tonight, Lee Jung-yeon dives into what that industry might look like for the country in the future.
Here's something not many people in Seoul have seen. Mini solar panels hanging outside apartment balconies. This residential area is a new energy-powered village with around 200 households producing solar energy.
I paid around $90 US, one-sixth of the cost. The rest was funded by the government. I've always been interested in renewable energy, so I'm glad to take part.
This one mini solar panel can produce around 300 watts of electricity, which is enough to run a refrigerator. It can cut electricity bills by between $6 and $8 US a month. This area shows what the city government is trying to achieve with its Solar City Seoul plan. So what prompted such a project?
Fossil fuels are causing huge climate change, so we're turning to renewable energy. Seoul's initiative is projected to produce 1 gigawatt of power by 2022, the equivalent of one nuclear power plant.
The city's goal is to get 1 million households to install mini solar panels and to increase the city's solar energy reliance to 3%. 15 billion won, or $14 million US, will be invested into solar energy over the next 5 years, and public facilities such as streetlights will be solar-powered. If this goal is accomplished, it will slash greenhouse gas emissions by about 540,000 tons, the equivalent of planting 8,000 pine trees. But on top of environmental effects, there are also economic benefits.
Expanding the solar energy industry will create more jobs. Also, the city will rely less on outside sources for energy and keep the money flowing within the region.
Because Seoul is a landlocked region that limits the use of other types of renewable energy, solar energy is its best option. And there's a part of Seoul that's been using it for the last 5 years.
Here in Gangdong-gu District is a village that's already making active use of solar energy. Most households here produce and consume their own electricity.
Sipjaseong Village is a model energy-powered village in Seoul. It was established in 1974 by Vietnam War veterans. A total of around 50 households in the village use solar panels, producing 45% of the village's total energy demand.
When the Fukushima nuclear disaster happened, it made us more aware of the need for renewable energy. So we have taken part in the solar energy project since 2012.
But not all residents were open to the idea from the start.
I actually didn't want to participate because I didn't know much about it, but now that we're involved, it's amazing. I don't know why the government didn't do this earlier.
The most obvious benefit? Lower electricity bills. Renewable energy is relatively new to Korea, but there are some places around the world that are already exploring its full potential. The Danish island of Samso has been producing more energy than it consumes for the past decade.
We are more than 100% self-supplied, and we have reduced the CO2 emissions, so we are now carbon negative. We actually have an emission of minus 3.7 tons per capita, which is, seen in a global perspective, very good.
One way to boost production is to increase citizen involvement.
60% of Seoul residents live in apartments, so citizens can form cooperatives to invest in solar panels and share the earnings.
But at the heart of citizen participation is awareness, and that's what some say is a priority.
But from being interested to actually invest your money in the project is a long way to go, because it takes a lot of convincing for people to invest their savings in a new technology they don't know about. So you can say information education is really key to the process of change.
The most effective way is to increase tax on electricity, which will make people more aware of how much they're using.
In reality, South Koreans only pay the standard value-added tax amount of 10% for electricity. This is in stark contrast to Denmark with 59% tax and Germany with 51%. As the Korean saying goes, we only see as much as we know. So many experts say the most important task is to educate the public and get them involved. And after that, everything else will follow suit. Lee Jeong-yeon, Arirang News.